If there is one team that's bound for the NCAA Final Four, it is the LPU Pirates. Coach Topex Robinson's team has lived up to preseason expectations, winning all their first seven games. While the Pirates have won some blowout games, they've also shown that they can win in close fights, even in hostile territory. Here with us is Coach Topex Robinson of the LPU Pirates. Hi, Coach Topex. Welcome to Game Time.
Yes, good evening, Mix.
Hello, Coach Topex. I mentioned about hostile territory. That past game in EAC was just really a wild one. Aminin natin, medyo we got out of hand. There was a possession there that you were called for two technicals in the same possession. What happened then? What was that like?
It's something that I apologize to the team after. I didn't manage my emotions, and it's a learning experience for me as a young coach, and it's an experience also for my players to lead.
Mm-hmm. And good thing for your team, coach, when you nung nag-exit kayo sa game, your assistant coaches took over, and then eventually you guys won that very, very tight and close game. But so far in the first seven games, what have you been doing best so far?
I think it's about us trusting each other, being on the same page, having that same vision, that same purpose, day in and day out. It's about inspiring others, always playing for a bigger cause. You know, it's really something deep that we always talk about and we always share. Mm-hmm. The court is a big stage for us to just inspire others.
Mm-hmm. Has there been a true test?
I guess it's the game against EAC where early in the game I was ejected. Again, empowering my coaches, Coach Jeff Perlas, Coach Romila Ducol, Coach Gilbert Malabanan. All of them are experienced coaches, and we have the same beliefs, I guess, and they want to win the game. Not just for me, but for the LPU community. Mm.
Coach Topex, everybody has been talking about CJ Perez, his entrance to the league, and his possible domination. But then in the first seven games, hindi pa natin talaga nakikita na nag-unleash the beast itong si CJ. But is this a good sign for you?
It's always about the team. CJ, okay, for sure, is the face of this team, but he knows that he's not better than his teammates.
Okay.
And it's given that he only averaging 20 plus minutes, and his scoring is not really that much. But if you're gonna look at our stats, it's really everybody. We have like a 13-man lineup, mm-hmm, that really helps each other out and trying to cover for each other.
Mm. Now, Coach, maybe the biggest revelation for this season was the Marcelino twins so far, JV and JC. But can you tell us more about their distinction, because they're really identical twins, and sometimes for us a panel, it's hard to distinguish who is who. But then for you, ano yung pagkakilala mo sa character nila? What sets them apart?
It's them really, really playing with a lot of heart. They came to me from Adamson, and then they just want to be given a chance, an opportunity, mm-hmm, together. Actually, the challenge for me is always bringing them together. Pagkapasok ng isa, for sure, sabay palagi. Not unless somebody gets into foul trouble or for that matter.
But off the bench, lagi sila sabay.
They're always gonna play together. All because right, they have this certain read. I guess because of them being twins, parang meron silang sariling play. Actually, they have this alley-oop play that they always play together. If you could see in our game one time, that transition pa lang, I already know that they're gonna do something. I'm just waiting for it to happen, uh-huh, but it's just a test of, you know, it's their willingness to really play for the team, you know, being recognized, also being given an opportunity that wasn't given to them. So they're just taking advantage of that opportunity.
Mm-hmm. And the Marcelino twins have been really broke out this season. One game, JV was the player of the game, and then the other game, it was JC naman. But then it was really, you know, a great sign for your team. You mentioned the coach earlier about stats, lesser minutes. And for me, that really brings me to Mike Harizuzu. He was the Rookie of the Year last year, averaging 20-20, just like Olwil Oraime. Pero ngayon, nag-drop talaga yung numbers niya and yung stats. But then for him, did he take on this role? Did he want this to be this way?
The thing with him is he's the supreme sacrifice. He wants to win a championship, and for him to win a championship, he knows that he has CJ around. You know, he told me that he's not worried about his stats, he's not worried about his touches. He just wants to win a championship, and he wants to be supporting CJ for whatever he could support, and and so far he's really been living to the challenge, and mm-hmm. he's really been a classic example of being submitting your ego for a bigger cause, and that's basically what's happening right now.
Mm, just like Mike Harris, Zuzu, coach, there were 10 players last year who were taken out of the team and completely formed a new lineup, but then for the guys who stayed, like Marata, for Baltazar and Kaduyak, they were playing more minutes last year, but then we've seen them take a lesser role or maybe take a quote-unquote back seat. For them, how did they take that also?
It was something that we've started right after season 92, sharing with them my vision or the vision of the team, where it's headed. They know that it's going to be CJ being the face of this team, and them really submitting their ego, supporting CJ or even the whole group. It's all about everybody. Even me as their head coach, I really made sure that I empower my coaches to to play a bigger role. One thing that I've learned is, first, you don't have to know everything. Mm-hmm. The second is you don't have to pretend that you know everything. So that means you're open to opinions, to them growing together. Even I have coaches there like Mike Harry, Mike Aya, even CJ, even Kaduyak. They're all been contributing to this purpose, and it's really nice to grow leaders. I guess my role I don't want to grow followers. I want to grow leaders. And I guess a testament to that was the game against AYAC again. After the game, they told me, "Coach, next time, let us know if you're gonna get ejected, so we'll prepare our own game plan." But again, it's about being vulnerable, admitting your mistake. I made a mistake. I got thrown out. It wasn't something that I wanted to do, but I said sorry to the team, and I'm gonna face the consequences of that. Mm-hmm. And it's about them taking the challenge, playing Letran this coming Friday without me, and knowing that they're just gonna give their best. Mm-hmm. You know, not guaranteeing us winning, but making sure that we're gonna play our very best to the best of our abilities.
Mm. And perhaps this total team effort on and off the court is the reason why, you know, the 7-0 start. Maybe perhaps backtracking, the recent one that we had this kind of record was with the Letran Knights in season 91, nun naka 7-0 din sila. And familiar also, we were talking about it, you were talking to Kevin Racal, and the same thing happened to their coach in Aldin Ayo. Ano yung conversation ni nun, coach?
Actually, he told me, coach, na, because we're gonna play Friday, so Kevin is sa Letran alumni, he told me, coach, ganyan din kami nangyari last time eh. Si Coach Aldin, na-thrown out, 7-0 kami, so sabi ko sa kanya, good thing yun kasi that was the time you guys won a championship. And hopefully, with this ejection and me not playing, I'm not really worried about sweeping the first. It's we never really expected this to happen. It's just a blessing for us. But hopefully, it's gonna turn out well for us. Wins is gonna be the result of what we're doing. Mm-hmm. It's always about inspiring others, mm-hmm. and always making this opportunity for a deeper cause. Mm.
And that may be just be an indicator lang, but it's not really, you know, a mm-hmm. guarantee maybe. But then, Coach Topex, from a range of 0 to 100%, in your own opinion, where are you at right now?
I hope we're 50%, and hoping that we could even improve. Mm-hmm. We've taken a lot of hits then, that teams are closing in on us. It's really hard for us coaches to, if you're there that you're not, walang hinahabol na team, mm-hmm. so it's hard to really make sure that these players are grounded. Mm-hmm. But it's always going back to challenging them that, saan ba kayo nanggaling before? Where were we 2 years ago? And where do we want to go? Mm-hmm. Kumbaga, the vision is there, malayo, hindi malinaw, but we want to make sure that every time we play, we always play in the moment. Mm-hmm. You know, what's in front of us? What's the opportunity there in front of us?
All right. Maraming salamat, Coach Topex. The last two games of LPU will be against Letran and against Mapua University. All right. Maraming salamat, Coach Topex. And see you in Season 93. Maraming salamat. Thank you. And that's all we have for today, sports fans.